Pigates, bonjour, ni hao, bonjour, I've already covered that one. Today I wanted to cover a look at, there are several issues related to choices one makes as you're about to purchase your car. The focus of this conversation is what to do about the color of your vehicle. Now, why is this a big deal? Well, it turns out that, for example, if you choose a black car, a black vehicle has a skin temperature that's on average 55 degrees higher than a vehicle with a white car. This matters, and it isn't a huge issue because when you look at the temperature inside the vehicle, you'll find that there's only a 6-degree difference between the inside of a black or a white car on a sunny day. With regular vehicles, this is no big deal because it's a few cents worth of gasoline. With an electric vehicle, the color choice of your vehicle could influence the range that you're giving up on a continuous basis for that vehicle. So if you watch all the numbers for Tesla, they usually reference what the mileage is for a vehicle. They do not cover what the mileage is based on impact of sun and distance that certain vehicles can go because of all the air conditioning that's being used to cool the car off because it's a black vehicle, for example. So I highly recommend that if you choose a color, do not choose black unless you live in a climate that's extremely cold. That would make it useful to have the car running hotter than normal on a regular basis. You also end up using up certain systems in the vehicle a lot more heavily related to air conditioning and other items. Another consideration that I wanted to suggest is I would highly recommend you not buy a red car. Red is kind of in the neutral zone, but one of the beauties of this vehicle is the fact that you can go out and speed on a regular basis, and because it looks like a sedan, not a Ferrari, the police aren't immediately attracting their eye to the vehicle you're driving. If you're interested in performance and enjoy doing 70, 80, 100 miles an hour and enjoying what the car can do, I highly recommend you avoid going for a red vehicle because it attracts too much attention, particularly of the police kind, if you enjoy leveraging the power and speed of the car. The other thing I wanted to note is that one of the best parts of Tesla is the fact that it can outperform most of the high-end vehicles that have big names, be it Porsche or Mercedes or Ferrari or Lamborghini, for that matter, all the way up to 70 or 80 miles per hour. As an auto writer, one of my most interesting lessons learned was the fact that those who drive vehicles that don't look like they can go fast get to speed regularly and don't get tickets or attract attention. And so you can go for the red vehicle if you'd like, but I think if you look at the data, you'll find out people driving red cars tend to get more tickets than any other color. The final note I wanted to make relative to the red color I found fascinating was that when I was giving test vehicles that were set up like race cars, I've had more police start following me and trying to give me tickets even if I didn't get them. And it limited my ability to enjoy the performance capabilities of that car. So again, I'd recommend you adjust the color of car that you choose according to where you live in the world or country and how many hours of daylight you have to either heat up or cool that car. The one last note I should make is that black is one of the coolest colors. We know that in terms of how it looks. It's obviously very hard to keep clean. It also creates a very hot car when you're in an environment that has a lot of sunshine. But theoretically, if you're in an environment that doesn't have a lot of sunshine, you might be inclined to go for a black car because the higher temperature that the car runs at all the time would be appealing versus having to use your heater to heat the car up. I would suggest that, you know, the other challenge with a black car is that it's harder to see at night. So therefore, you have a higher likelihood of people running into you. So again, as you go into the process of selecting how you're going to put your vehicle together, the color you choose for that vehicle can significantly be an issue, especially with an electric vehicle, because all the other work that's being put out by the vehicle for air conditioning to cool or heat your car is going to be influential on how many miles you're able to get out of it. So I highly recommend you avoid black. And even though red is a neutral color, I'd also avoid that one. Any of the other colors are going to be in the middle of the range and, you know, don't have much of an impact. You know, I also have to admit would shy away from darker colors if you're in an area that's very hot with a lot of sunshine. Best of luck and look forward to more. Please like and subscribe.